Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, bonitas, bonitos, muchachos, muchachas. Welcome to the Musical King Radio Show, where every Thursday I bring you one song. One big tune looking for everyone teaching on the platform, and I think you should know about. Hey yo, tune in the back. I'm a man of many words, I beat you in Scrabble. When that I do my own stunts, I don't need no tattoo. I got for him, but tonight I settle. How you pop a lock and drop it, you deserve. You hot like a rocket, like a tea in a kettle. Give me breakfast, give me lunch, give me dinner. You're now locked on to the Musical King Radio Show. We are Shooty ASEM. Wonderful, glorious Thursday. Hey, mom. All the pretty girls wanna love with. All the bad bitches wanna fuck with. All the real ones know I'm there. Yes, all the real ones know. And I am the one, and this is the Musical King Radio Show with ASEM. In case you don't know, in case you're unaware, tune in the back of it from the man, the boy, the myth, the legend, ASEM, and he calls this song Noir, off his highly anticipated The Forecast 1.0, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. More music on the way. Big tune pan the way. Weather channel coming soon. This is the Musical King Radio Show. What is going on in the world? Another eventful week. And if you go on Spotify and you search for ASEM Afro Grooves, you can find this tune with other bad vibes that me, myself, and I curate for your listening pleasure. What's going on in the world? Politics, as usual. And all week, the conversation has been about Representative George Santos, a Republican from Long Island, was indicted on federal charges, including wire fraud and money laundering. If you guys heard about George Santos, he's the Long Island Republican representative who fabricated his resume and he embellished his background story and his political journey. That's a different case in the style. Now federal charges have been filed against him in terms of indictment when it comes to money laundering. Okay, prosecutors charged Santos in three schemes. One involves pocketing donations to fake super PAC. So people are concerned about where he got his donations from when he was running for office. Did he go through all the background checks before he was able to use their monies? He pleaded not guilty and plans to stay in office. It looks like, I watched the press conference, George Santos looks like he's taking some rules out of the Trump book. We live to see more news. Sorry, Donald Trump revived lies about 2020 election and praised January 6th rioters at an unruly CNN town hall. Here's the fact check. So yes, Trump was, I don't even know whether you call it, he was charged. The case with E. Jean Carroll, like a columnist, journalist from back in the day who accused Trump of sexual abuse. And now the New York courts found her. They fined Donald Trump $5 million or something like that. The EPA will announce the first regulations to limit pollution. Biden is working moderate Republicans in deep selling, trying to convince them to break away from Speaker McCarthy. So yes, also the conversation about the flag bearership and Joe Biden's 2023 electoral runoff again. People in the Democratic Party feel that Joe Biden should stand unopposed, and it's a lot going on with also the Republican Party and whether Donald Trump is going to be the candidate because of all the like legal battles he's going through. That's a lot of stuff going on this week with Trump and also George Santos. The Republican Party definitely getting all the miles when it comes to news coverage. Biden is still on the debt ceiling. There was also some student loan cancellation going on with Joe Biden. Let's talk about more cheery and more dairy stuff. Talking about football and soccer, where the Champions League games went on. The Champions League games, the creme de la creme, Manchester City and Real Madrid have proven to be the best teams in Europe and in the world based on the game they played yesterday, where Inter Milan beat AC Milan 2-0, but it was the worst AC Milan performance I've ever seen. I mean, the first half, AC Milan was so deplorable. You would, I mean, even though in the Serie A, Inter have beaten them 3 times already. I thought their history in the Champions League would give them some spirit and momentum, but their performance was nothing to write home about. Inter Milan beat AC Milan 2-0 yesterday. I'm not really looking forward to the second leg. I feel like Inter Milan have made it to the final, and Manchester City and Real Madrid will be the next team that will face them. Okay, Champions League. Today, UEFA Europa League is also back. Mouth-watering clashes where Roma is playing Leverkusen and Juventus is playing Sevilla. So Roma from Italy playing Bayer Leverkusen from Germany and Juventus from Italy playing Sevilla from Spain. So like I said, the Italian teams are making a comeback. But do they have what it takes to lift any trophy? We live to see. Jose Mourinho's Roma is playing against Leverkusen. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, new ASGM music collection, available on our platform. Click the link in the bio. More music on the way. What up, y'all? Coming soon. This is the Music Radio Show. We'll be back.